Hey everybody, Kenny here. Just a couple quick items in the Atomic Shop this week. We're going to take a look at the Mr. Fuzzy Power Armor Helmet, the cash registers, and also the Warhead paint for your Fallout First members. So the three registers are all the same exact size and pretty much the same exact shape, and they have the same size base there. You've got your Nuka-Cola one on the left, your gold one in the middle, and here on the right, this one that definitely looks like it fits a Western theme, so that's why I went ahead and placed these Western style counters here. Unfortunately, one thing that's a bit of a nitpick is that they are all a bit too long and they all overhang that counter, so kind of annoying. It would have been nice to have that shaved off just a hair, but again, just a bit of a nitpick. They do have an animation, but the animation only happens when you first power them on, so we'll take a look at that now. You know, it'd be really nice if they did this every time somebody engaged with the register, but as you can see, nothing happens. So, but other than that, they look fantastic, and I look forward to seeing these in other people's shops. A slight concern, though, is that maybe players won't recognize these as vending machines because they're so used to the larger vending machines. So be sure to keep that in mind. Maybe place a regular vendor nearby just to make sure you don't accidentally have your visitors miss your vending machine. So. Next up, we're going to take a look at this power armor here. I've got the Mr. Fuzzy power armor helmet on it right now, but that's your Warhead armor. And the cool thing about this armor is that when you turn on the light, the teeth light up. Like so. There's your light. And the same thing happens with the... Where is it? The Warhead helmet. With the visor there. So, awesome stuff. Definitely like the detail on that. Oh, come on, step out. There we go. And let's see, next up, we are going to talk about the Kenpole of the week. And Season 4 brought us the Locked and Loaded patch, of course. Now, I'm curious about the daily ops. There's been a lot of talk about those. I've noticed a lot fewer players playing them. Compared to how they used to be, so I threw up the poll on that. And the three options are, do you guys like the new challenge to it? You don't like the new challenge to it, and you'd like to see them undo it? Or you just don't have any preference on it? So those are the three options. I probably should have had a fourth option of just scale back the challenge a little bit, which probably would have taken it. But so far, 80% of the votes are people loving the new challenge. So maybe I'm just unlucky on the new servers, on the servers I'm at. Maybe nobody's there playing it, because I maybe get one or two other people, but not as often as I used to. So I do think they need to increase the rewards, though, however, considering how it's more challenging. But I think that's the way they are implemented now. It's probably how they originally intended them to be, you know, kind of like a more of an in-game thing for players that have finished all the quests. So in general, I'm happy about it, but I do think they need to balance it about, because I really don't like it getting instantly killed, you know, without any chance to defend myself. So there's that. But other than that, folks, take care, and I will see you in the wasteland. Bye-bye.